Hey guys, performance coach Mike Salemi here, and in just a few seconds, I'm going to be breaking down the top three things you need to focus on if you truly want to learn and master the Double Kettlebell Gorilla Clean. Let's go. So this has got to be, without a doubt, one of my favorite of all kettlebell movements. The reason being is we're training speed, power, acceleration, deceleration. We're really working that coordination element of the upper body and the lower body to work in unison. And it incorporates one of my favorite total body movements, the kettlebell clean. So if we look at the three criteria that I really try to focus on and establish and teach my students to really hone in on this movement, the first has to do with the torso positioning. Now, if we were to compare this movement to, let's say, a double kettlebell clean, a more classic hinge-based or a Russian-based clean, one of the key differences that you'll notice is on that type of clean, the hips are going to hinge back. Really, we're focusing on a stretch loading of the hamstrings and the glutes. And when you perform that type of clean, the torso angle is, let's say, somewhere around a 45 degree angle. It can vary on the individual, certainly a little less, a little bit more. But on a more Russian or hinge-based clean, the torso is going to be forward leaning. Because once again, we're really trying to accentuate the glutes, hamstrings, and also the lower back working on that movement. But if we compare it to, let's say, the double kettlebell gorilla clean, how that's different is on this type of movement, we're utilizing a more vertical path. So it's more up and down. You're learning how to, once again, accelerate vertically up explosively without getting the benefit of that backswing. Now, with a more vertical or an upright torso position, I want to show you exactly why this is important when it comes to establishing a safe and secure rack position on this lift. So one of the things is, if you notice here, my torso position is pretty upright, but if I incorporated more of a hip hinge mechanics, this is what would happen. So if I caught here, now this is a light enough bell to where I can hold it in position, you'll notice that the bell wants to fall from the rack position. So that's one main reason why I want to establish a vertical chest position, so that way I can keep the kettlebell in a nice secure spot. The other thing that this more upright torso position does is it's going to work more of the anterior chain. It's going to work more of the quads working. You'll see that the knees need to jet forward. If the knees go back, the further the knees go back, it's going to be working more of the hamstrings and the glutes. So one of the key factors to establish that vertical torso position has to do with adequate mobility around the ankles. Now, I can't tell you how many times I've had students or people having issues with ankle mobility. The more restricted your ankles are, that's gonna force you. If my knees can't come forward because of a restriction in the ankle, it's going to send the hips back. So if you're performing this movement and you're having challenges, one of the first things I would wanna focus on as it relates to helping you establish that vertical torso position is addressing the restriction at the ankles. Could be calf tightness, soleus tightness, could even be like a bony restriction in the ankle joint itself. But just a few things that you want to take a look at and address if you're having challenges maintaining that vertical torso position. The second thing I want to go over has to do with the coordination of the upper body. Now, the best tip that I can give you is to focus on the raising arm. A lot of times people get confused in terms of what arm should I be focusing on? Should it be the lowering hand? Should it be the raising hand? Just focus, or both at the same time, just focus on the raising arm. So, for example, on here, when I dip down, I'm focusing on my left arm, just driving up. The right arm's gonna fall naturally by itself. So if I just focus on the raising arm and let the other arm fall. The second tip I wanna give you in terms of how to coordinate the upper body better has to do with the rack position, or better said, the insertion position. So insertion is simply how the hand drives through the kettlebell handle. You'll notice that my hand is fully inserted into the kettlebell so that the handle hits and forms that 45 degree angle. We don't want to set this position. This is pretty unstable for the wrist. I want to fully insert my hand as much as possible. And because this movement happens so rapidly and so fast, I leave my hands open the whole time, so I don't close them over. Compared to, let's say, a more classic clean where I'm here, this one, you still want the shoulders down to a fair extent, but you can let them spread apart a little bit more. You just don't want them high up here where the bell's resting on the shoulders, but you can certainly spread them out. And a lot of times if I keep my hands open, makes it a lot easier to quickly drive that hand through the kettlebell. The last thing I want to focus on, number three, has to do with the coordination of the movement. How can you be explosive and relaxed and repeat that explosiveness from the first rep to the last rep? And it's intimately connected with the breathing rhythm. So when you're performing this, one tip is to, as the bell falls, so as the arm extends down, I'm gonna exhale. During the transition phase, I'm gonna inhale. Then as the other arm straightens, I'm gonna exhale. So it's inhale during the transition, exhale during when the arm is straight. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. When you're inhaling, you're coming into full extension, and when you exhale, that's the dip phase. So from here, that's my exhalation rep, and I'm really trying to focus on being as explosive as possible coming up. So those are your three tips. Focus on that vertical torso position, number one. Number two, focus on the raising phase of that arm when it comes to coordinating the upper body. And number three, sync the lowering phase with the exhalation breath. So sync the breath with the movement. As you dip, you explosively drive up. So those are your three tips. If you have any questions on just the clean in general, definitely check out my program, Mastering the Kettlebell. It's got well over 50 videos on mastering the clean, assessments for the clean, how you can incorporate flexibility exercises for, once again, those ankles, whatever may be holding you back. Check it out, it's a fantastic program. Would love for you to take a look. Also, if you like this video, please do comment, share, let me know how I can help you more, how this video was helpful, or if you'd like any other video as well, would love to create it for you. I wish you the very best in your lifting. Happy kettlebells. Peace out, everyone.